Bonjour à toutes et bonjour à tous, je me trouve aujourd'hui avec le senior producer de Riggs, qui est un jeu de PlayStation VR qui s'appelle Lucas, mais son nom est très difficile à prononcer. Why don't you present yourself?
Yeah, so my name is Lucas van Muiswinkel, which is a really hard name to pronounce, and I'm one of the producers in Guerrilla Cambridge, and we make Riggs for PlayStation VR, and we're really excited to show a new map in Paris today.
So please, can you explain to me what the game is about?
Yeah, so the full title of the game is Riggs Mechanized Combat League.
Yes.
And it's a first-person arena shooter. But it's not just a shooter, it's a sport. It's like the combat sport of the future. So, you know, it's set about 60 years into the future or so, where you become the pilot of these giant mechanized fighting machines we call Riggs. Yes. And they're like the enormous machines with two guns. And what you do is you use them in teams of three to fight each other in what we call, in this mode, is called Power Slam. So the biggest difference from like what you would say in a normal regular shooter is it's not just about killing it, and in fact it's not about killing at all, it's about working together as a team to score goals and points.
Yes.
So it's quite refreshing, really new concept, and we really, really think it's suitable for PlayStation VR.
Yeah, I saw the trailer at the press conference of Sony, and I didn't quite understand how you make points and what the shooting is about, because we have to make goals.
Someone once described it as a basketball with guns, and I like that. But so what you do with Riggs is actually you have to become the ball, as if you were to compare it to basketball. So what you do is you take down opponents, and if you take down three opponents, then you go into what we call overdrive. So you fill up a meter with energy, and you can also do that by collecting orbs that are scattered around the level. But as soon as you collect enough of those, you go into what we call overdrive, and at that point in time, you become the ball that can score. So you jump through the goal in the middle of the map.
Okay.
And that's really interesting, because you can always, of course, everyone can go into overdrive at any time. So you can see enemies also running for the goal. So defending in this case means that you have to find enemies that if you see that they're in overdrive, go after them and go get them. Because not only do you get energy from them, but you also prevent them from scoring.
Yeah, okay. So you have to make a goal, and you have to, and the opponent needs to kill you, so you don't have to.
Well, it's not killing. So
it's killing for sport.
So it's taking down. So you actually in Riggs you never really die. You eject.
Yes.
So the only thing that happens is your rig gets destroyed and you get ejected up into the air. So that's why it's more like a sport as well. So that whole sports theme comes back in everything, including that it's not killing. It's taking down enemies. Yep.
What did you choose to make it a PlayStation VR game?
Well, so we are a first party studio, and that means that we have the privilege sometimes to get a sneak preview of what's brewing in the kitchen of Sony. And as soon as we got our hands on the first development kits of PlayStation VR, we started thinking about, wow, what can we do with this technology? And actually what that meant is that Riggs is a game that has been designed from the ground up to be a VR game. And I think that shows, because like it feels really natural. And I think the sensation you get when you go into the game and you put the VR headset on and it transports you into the world of Riggs. Yeah, that is just a feeling that I cannot really describe. You have to be there and experience it, and then you will be a believer of VR.
Yes, PlayStation VR helps the player to feel in the universe of the game.
Yeah. Yeah. So that everybody also always uses the sense of immersion, but it is true. But everybody always uses that word, and that's because you're no longer controlling a character in a game, you are the pilot in the game. So you are in the cockpit, you look down and you see your hands on the controls, you look to the right and you see the guns of your machine, you see the other gun, and that's the difference. Like, you become the pilot of the superstar of the future, and that's nothing I've ever made before in the games. It is absolutely amazing and special.
Do you believe that the game will be in the future export game?
Well, that's a very good question, and I know on stage it was also mentioned as like a VR esport. So what we did with Riggs is actually design it in a way that it can be played competitively and that you can play strategically, which means that it could be suitable to become an esport. But we can't say this is an esport because that grows from a community. So what we try to do is make a game that is suitable for it and stimulate it and make sure that people understand what it's all about, and then see where the PlayStation VR community takes it from there. And we can help.
Your first game was Killzone Mercenary.
Yeah, the last game we did in Cambridge. Yeah.
It was a PlayStation Vita game, so it's quite different. Is it quite different to do a game for PlayStation Vita and then to jump on PlayStation VR?
Yeah, that's a really good question, actually. So I think they are different in the sense that Vita is, of course, a different platform than the PlayStation VR platform. But we have a lot of experience in actually porting using the Killzone Shadowfall engine, or the Killzone engine as it were, and making it suitable for a new platform, actually. So we did that for the Vita, and now we did it again for the PlayStation VR. So that's part one of experience, you know, that helped us with this game. But also, I think that when we built Killzone Mercenary, the multiplayer component of that was very similar to Riggs in the terms that there was slightly smaller maps with less enemies, so it's also a similar amount of enemies, and the experience we got in the competitive multiplayer on that, which was also really quite a successful game, then it actually means that we transferred a lot of those skills and elements in level design and game design and mechanics design that you can see are reflected in Riggs.
Okay, thanks. It's an all multiplayer game, or is it also a single player mode?
So what we are currently showing and what we have as a demo is a 3v3 multiplayer game.
Yes.
And what we're currently looking at is what we could do for when you're not online and when you're not playing a competitive game. But we're not quite ready to make announcement about any of that.
Okay.
We are just here to talk about the Power Slam game mode.
The game takes place in the future, so is it a universe that is it developed in the game?
No, it takes place on Earth. It's just happening about 60-65 years into the future. And what we did is choose locations that we think are going to be current 60 years into the future. So we showed a map in Rio before at E3, and this week in Paris we have a world exclusive where we showed a new map is taking place in Dubai. So
yes.
that's what we want to do. We create bespoke mega arenas that are actually built for this sport, because we feel that Riggs is going to be the sport of the future. So we try to do that with how and where we built our arenas.
When did you expect the game to be released?
So we only can speak about a year, which is next year. So we're targeting a 2016 release. But when that is, you're going to have to wait and see until we get closer to that important release date.
I think that would be all. Thank you for your time.
Cool.
The game looks amazing. I can't wait to play it.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to hearing your feedback.
Okay, of course.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.